career here. Back in 04 when I graduated West Point, I was an FSO and third of the 319th field artillery. I was a Fister and the Fist team there for first of the 504th. So I was a gun devil for the Mid Devils. And I loved life. I was only here a year, and then fortunately I was able to assess and went to the 75th Ranger Regiment and spent most of my career there until I decided to get out. So I've been very blessed. I was speaking in Charlotte for an event at my grandfather for veterans. And Dad had asked me years ago, "Son, I need your help. Would you come work for me?" And I told him no. And I was stuck in an airplane with him. My dad's a pilot. And we were in Alaska, and I couldn't go anywhere. So I just remember looking out the door of the plane, and I just kind of gave him a quick nudge. I was like, "Dad, I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be." And I was. Dad never bothered me again. To be honest, what I feared was my father's ministry that the Lord had given my father. Never wanted to do anything about it. Never part of it. When my grandfather passed away, we're sitting there watching on TV, and General Tobo calls me into his office, and we're watching the stuff on TV, and he's already yelling at me for not leaving. He thought I should be up there with some of it. I don't like D.C., so I was going to stay away for as long as possible, and then go from there. But we're sitting there watching, he asked me, "Edward, do you ever want to do this?" I said, "No, sir, I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be." And I was. But I was still dealing with fear. I think one of the best scriptures that helped me understand, and after I talked with my funny uncle, Uncle Dick, I went home that night and I was struggling. Because you remember I said, hey, I would come if something happened to my father. But I went back and I read Matthew, and in chapter 14, verse 27, it says, "But Jesus immediately said to them, 'Take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid.' 'Lord, if it is you,' Peter recalled, 'tell me to come to you on the water.' 'Come,' he said. But Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid. Beginning to sink, he cried out, 'Lord, save me.' Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and called him. 'But you, little faith,' he said, 'why did you doubt?' And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Those that were on the boat worshipped him, saying, 'Truly, you are the Son of God.'" So I read that, and you're probably wondering, well, what does that have to do with your fear? If you want to be a part of a miracle, you got to get out of the boat. I think in my own life, in the Army, I was comfortable here. I was in my comfort zone. I'm not gung-ho, I'm not the best Ranger, I'm not the best soldier. But I was comfortable. It was easy. I just told you the easiest job I ever had was Ranger Company Commander, to include combat, because I was surrounded by talent. I wasn't challenging myself. I wasn't scared. If you see in this story, you look at Peter, Jesus was in the middle of the storm, walking out to him. Peter had to get out of the boat with all that waves and all that wind and walk to what he was afraid of, into what he was afraid of. So we always pray, "Lord, what is your will for me? What is your plan for me?" And I've been praying that for years. I think when I realized I had to go the direction that I'm most afraid of and what I feared the most, and it wasn't the military anymore. So one day, you'll get out. But I ask right now, this room, if you're going to pray, pray for how the Lord is going to use you. What does he have in store for you here? But also when you get out, when you grow up, what are you going to do? I use that term because General Togo said, "I'm growing up now, I got to go do something else." It's not my turn, but one day you'll grow up. For you young ones in the room, be praying that. And for those that are older, it's not too late. It's never too late. It wasn't too late for me. Don't make what you have on your shoulder your identity. My identity, like I said, is in my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I hope it will be for you.